Hello, friends, and welcome to Escaping the Mouse with your host, me, Breck Roll. All right, I just got a couple things I want to talk to you about today. First off, I know you've been following what's going on with my dad for a while. You know he ended up back in the hospital recently, and he actually started off in a rehab facility, and then they ended up updating him to a hospital a few days ago. Apparently, what we're still doing is we're still fighting a little bit to get his blood chemistry under control. As you know, he's got issues with his liver, and the primary purpose of the liver is to kind of act as a filter for the blood, and when it isn't functioning properly, you need a lot of medication and stuff like that to control what's going on. And specifically, one of the things that we're most concerned about is controlling his ammonia level. And he's on medication that's supposed to do that, but he's having problems, I think, kind of getting the right dosage at the right time. And it's partly just because I think sometimes he gets a little forgetful, and it's partly because the dosages and the combinations of medicines he's taking is changing all the time while they try and, you know, find the exact right balance for him. So as of Tuesday, a few days ago, he was really out of it and incoherent. And my mom said she went down to visit him in the hospital, and he seemed almost barely aware that she was there. Day before, she had talked to him, and my mom isn't the most technical person in the world, so she kind of depends on my father to do a number of the things to help her. And one of the things she's not really good with is dealing with some of the things on her phone. When she gets gets too many voicemails in there, that she's got to empty the voicemails. She just has a little trouble doing that. So she talked to my father about that, and he said, "Yeah, just bring the phone down, and I'll get it cleared up for you." And normally that'd be a very simple thing for him to do. Well, when she brought it down on Tuesday, you know, he was in one of his kind of out of it states, and she said, "Can you give me, you know, can you empty my voicemail, empty my voicemails from my phone?" And he kind of gave her kind of a non-committal answer. He handed her the phone, or she handed him the phone, and he just kind of fumbled around with it a little bit and just couldn't figure out even how to do it. So, you know, like I said, they left him in the hospital. They've been working on his meds, trying to get his ammonia level back down again. And over the last couple of days, he's been really improving a lot. Now, what they want to do is they don't want to send him home immediately, because apparently last time he was in the hospital, they sent him home before he was ready. So what they want to do is, while they're ready to discharge him from the hospital, they want him to go into a rehab facility for a while. And it's sort of my mom's hope, I think, that he stay in that rehab facility until they're ready to move into their assisted living place. We think the greatest thing that'll come from living in the assisted living place is that the staff there can begin taking control of his meds. Because what ends up happening is, if he forgets to take something, then his ammonia levels start going out of control, and he stays in bed, and he doesn't eat, and then he doesn't take his meds even more, and just goes downhill from there. So I think having him in the assisted living place will help a lot, because then they can kind of take care of the meds and make sure he's getting the right thing at the right time, and keep track of all the changes and stuff that's going on, so that he's constantly getting the right stuff and the right doses at the right time. And hopefully we'll be able to control that. You know, we kind of think that's what's going on, because one of the observations we've made is that he doesn't ever have these ups and downs when he's in the hospital. And when he's in the hospital, the doctors and nurses are controlling his meds. The ups and downs only seem to be at home, when he's at home, when he's controlling his own meds. And even my mom's tried helping him a little bit with the meds, but, you know, like I said, it's really complicated, because the doses are changing, the combinations of things are changing, you know, all the time, and they just necessarily can't keep up with it. So I think, you know, once we get him into the rehab, or once we get him into the assisted living place, he'll be much better off. And right now, we think it's just a good idea that he stay in a rehab facility for a brief time One, because they can also control his meds, make sure he's getting the right thing. And two, they can ensure that he's getting out of bed and getting physical therapy every day, which he really needs to do, you know, if he's going to regain his strength and get back to living a reasonably normal life. So at this point, we're looking like we're going to leave him in the rehab facility, at least until my mom gets moved into her new senior assisted living place, which is supposed to happen early next month. Turns out that they've already made arrangements to get a mover to help move into the new apartment, and that's going to happen kind of in the middle of the month. And they have a new bed that's going to be coming in for them, because their old king-size bed won't fit in the room. And they're going to get one of those like adjustable bed things so that, you know, they can sit up. And my understanding is this thing will even help my dad get to his feet. So I guess it doesn't just, you know, adjust the back. It'll actually stand him up on that. I've never seen that before, but that's kind of what I've heard. And that sounds like that'd be a good thing. Anything to help encourage him to get out of bed more often and, you know, join the real world, because that's what needs to happen. So things are going forward on that. I know my mom and dad both appreciate your thoughts and prayers, so please keep those coming, because I appreciate them too. Now next, I mentioned a couple days ago that I have a job interview coming up. Now I'm going for that job interview on Saturday, and I think you're going to probably see this the day after it. So hopefully by the time you've seen this, that interview will be over. I'm not going to tell you a whole lot about where it is, because unfortunately I got to keep some of these aspects of my life private, just to avoid, you know, some of the trolls that are out there. I hope you understand that. But what this is, it's going to be a graveyard shift job, regular full-time. So it's going to be good for me. You know, I'm a night person anyway, you know. I've always been somebody that kind of gravitates being up at night anyway, and do well when I have to do like overnight shifts. I know I did that about a year ago for Disney, when the parade shut down for an extended period of time and they loaned us to another department. And that department was the department that was putting Christmas lights up on the Small World attraction. And I worked overnight, you know, for about 6 weeks during that time period. And, you know, once I had kind of adapted to it and kind of got myself acclimated to it, you know, I did really fine. You know, it was a job where I'd go into work about 10 o'clock at night and stay till 6 or 7 in the morning. And I did just fine with that. So I think I'll do fine with it here, too. It will enable me to do, you know, a little bit of vlogging on during the weeks, you know, when I'm working, you know, because if it's an 8-hour shift, then I can, you know, come home and do vlogs, you know, a little bit in the evening. It may not be as many going out and seeing things and going places vlogs, but, you know, we'll play that by ear. You know, who knows what I'll be able to go see, you know, when, you know, there's nothing to say in the world that says that once I'm done with my shift at 6 or 7 or whenever I get off, that I can't come home, go out, do something in the morning, and then come home, go to bed, and work that way. So I'm going to try and keep things going on that, but, you know, wish me luck on that interview. Hopefully by the time, like I said, by the time you see this, that will already be over, and hopefully it went well, keeping my fingers crossed. Now, one other thing, you know that recently I updated the memory in my computer, and at the advice of the guy who gave me, you know, I got some advice about the memory from a local computer guy that I talked to. He recommended that I put a video card in the machine also. And I had a little bit of a problem with that. It turns out when I put the video card in there, it wouldn't work. And I ended up calling the manufacturer of the card, and they recommended that I look into the BIOS in the computer. Now, I don't know how much a lot of you probably don't know a lot about computers, but the BIOS is a chip that's on the motherboard that basically tells the computer how to communicate with all of the devices in there. And it's the first thing that goes on before you even start booting on the hard drive, because you need to know what devices are installed in there. Well, this guy recommended that it's possible that the the board or the connector that the video board connected to was disabled, because a lot of times they'll disable it, especially when there's a video board built onto the motherboard. You know, you don't want to have conflicts between two different video boards, so they'll disable the secondary one and enable the onboard one. And the guy recommended that I check that, but wasn't really able to help me a whole lot beyond that, because every BIOS is a little bit different. And so he didn't know specifically what I had. So he recommended that I actually contact the computer manufacturer and get them to walk me through this. Well, when I was having problems with the memory, I tried contacting them, and they very happily alerted me that my warranty was up, and that if they were going to help me, I was going to have to pay them a service charge to do that. And I figured, you know what, if I do that, and if I, you know, pay them, and they do resolve this BIOS problem, help me figure out what's going on there, that's not a guarantee that's not going to be the only problem. And then I'm just going to have to pay someone else to deal with whatever that other problem was. So I decided, since I'd talked to this computer guy, and he'd given me some advice for free, basically, that I was going to give him a real chance to work on that and actually make a little money. So I sent him in the computer, and he messed around with it for about a day, was able to find out exactly what had gone on, and it was indeed that the slot that the video card attaches to wasn't enabled, and he found the appropriate setting in the BIOS, enabled it, and got the whole thing to work. Well, when I got home and plugged it into my system, got everything tried to hook up again, it still didn't work. And now I think I have a bigger problem, because while I could make the computer work, you know, before when I didn't have that extra slot enabled, I could still plug the video board in, or the monitor into the video board that was on the motherboard, and make it work. Well, now I can't get anything to come up, and I think I got some other little bit of a problem, so I'm gonna have to go back and talk to this guy again and see what's going on there, see if he can figure out what this is. So, you know, right now I'm doing all my video editing on the laptop, and fortunately I have the backup that I can do that, but unfortunately I don't have all my great tools. You know, I don't have Photoshop on there, I don't have my audio editor on there, and don't even really have access to a lot of the files that I need. So videos may be a little bit primitive over the next couple days. Apologize for that, but we are working on the issue, and the videos will continue to come out, even though they may not be quite as polished as they normally are. So I hope you understand that. We'll get that wrapped up hopefully in the next day or so, and things should be better off. So anyway, I think that is all that I have for today. I would like to thank my newest Patreon, Daniel Roseman. Thank you so much for contributing to my channel. It's been fun talking to you the last couple days, and I appreciate you supporting me. So anyway, that's all I have for today. Thank you as always for watching, and I will see you next time on Escaping the Mouse. Good night.